Have you ever found yourself wondering how to make your Google Form accessible to everyone without a hassle? Today, we're going to walk through every step to make your Google Form public so that anyone can fill it out. I'm Sissy with JotForm, and in this video, we're covering everything from the very first steps of logging into your account to adjusting the sharing settings and even exploring why you might want to make your form public. Whether you're setting up a survey, registration, or a simple feedback form, this guide has you covered. Let's get into it. One of the easiest ways to gather quick feedback from lots of people is by setting up an online survey with a tool like Google Forms. However, if you want to collect the responses you need, you have to know how to make your Google Form public. Otherwise, people simply can't access it. To avoid this hassle, it's important to learn how to share your forms and surveys with customers, fans, or anyone ready to offer useful insights. Bringing in fresh perspectives can really help you understand your audience better, especially what they're looking for in your product or service. The great news is that once you figure out how to make your Google Form public, you'll be able to gather all that valuable intel effortlessly. By making your Google Form public, you break down accessibility barriers and open it up to a wider range of respondents who can offer new, unique viewpoints. It's a straightforward, seamless, and secure way to share your survey and get the feedback you need. Just remember, while people can fill out your public form, they won't have the ability to edit it or alter its content. Now let's take you through the interactive step-by-step tutorial. The first step is simple. Log into your Google account and open the specific form you want to make public. If you haven't created a form yet, go ahead and create the form. Add your title and all of the questions you want in your form. Second, you'll want to go to the Settings tab and click on the arrow next to Responses. Third, you'll want to look for the setting that says Requires Sign-In. There are two settings there that you'll want to toggle to the off position. The first one says Restrict to User In, and the second one says Limit to One Response. Make sure both of these are marked off. Fourth, you'll want to share the form, so you'll click the purple Send button in the top right corner. Fifth, you'll have to choose how you want to share your form. Once you click the Send button, you'll see multiple icons. The envelope icon refers to email. It allows you to add a subject line and content inviting users to fill out your form. You can also embed the form in your email. The link icon allows you to share your form via a custom link. The icon with the arrows allows you to embed the form on your website using HTML code. And finally, the social media icons to the right allow you to share your form directly on Facebook or X. Now that you've shared your form, you can track and manage your responses easily. Just click on Responses at the top and then click on the green Google Sheets icon that says Link to Sheets. There is a chance you'll want to add collaborators. So let's discuss how you go about doing that. You can allow collaborators or coworkers access to edit and revise the form. You just need to adjust the permissions. Click on the three dots next to the Send button. Then click on Add Collaborators. You'll see the General Access section has some options. First, you'll see Restricted Access, which means only the people with the link can access the form. You can specify who has access by adding their email to the Add Editors section. Next, you'll see the name of your organization. That means everyone in your organization has access. The last option is Anyone with a link, which leaves the form open to anyone on the internet with access to edit the form. There is a difference between making your forms public but not editable by the public. The only way someone is able to edit your form is if you add their email as a collaborator, or when you send them the form via email, you can add them as an editor. If you haven't given someone access to edit, they won't be able to edit your form. If Google Forms feels too basic for what you need, try a more powerful form builder like JotForm. This platform gives you flexible access controls, so you can decide exactly who can see and fill out your form. In JotForm's Form Builder, you simply open the Access Settings menu and pick the level of sharing that works best. Make your form completely public, share it with only people who have a link, or restrict it to anyone using your company's email domain. Gathering feedback from your audience is essential, no matter what industry you're in or the type of organization you run. To do this well, it's important to ensure that your surveys and questionnaires are easily accessible to the people you're trying to reach. Thank you so much for watching today. I'm Sissy with JotForm, and I hope you found this guide clear and helpful. Don't forget to hit subscribe if you enjoyed this walkthrough, and I look forward to seeing you next time as we explore more ways to make your digital tools work for you. Until then, keep experimenting and making your forms as accessible as possible.